Hey class, and welcome to the week 9 material. So last week we started out on landfills and we took a look at all the engineering systems present at landfills, the liner system, leachate collection system, final cover system. This week we're going to move forward and look at what do we do with that leachate once it's collected? What do we do with that landfill gas to collect it? Hey class, and welcome to the week 9 material. So last week we started off looking at landfills. We talked about landfill construction and operations. We talked about the liner system, the leachate collection system, and the final cover system. This week we're going to keep going on landfills. So we'll look at what do we do with that leachate when we get it collected in our leachate collection system? What's the next step? We'll look at the best ways to extract landfill gas. And we've looked at how to use landfill gas already in chapter 5. But we'll talk about how we get it out and what you're going to do with it if you're not going to use it, which is to flare it off. We'll also look at what do we do when it's time to close a landfill? What are the duties of a landfill owner to keep doing? And then how do you actually use that land for something useful? Is it going to be just an abandoned land forever? Or are there better things we can do? And how do we actually do those things in the specifics of a landfill context? So to start off this topic, we're going to go back, and if you think of when we were talking in our last video about the leachate collection system, what do we do with that leachate once it's in our system? So just to talk about, get our heads back into leachate for a minute. So leachate is either a primary leachate coming out of the waste itself or a secondary leachate, which is water that's gotten into the waste after it's been placed. So it's spent its time around the waste. It's picked up all these degradation products of the waste or solubilized parts of the waste, comes down, makes its way down to the bottom of the landfill, gets into the leachate collection system, and it gets pumped out. So what does that leachate look like? Well, typically it's high in solids. It's high in nitrogen, and compared to domestic wastewater, which you might have more experience with, leachate tends to have a high nitrogen to phosphorus ratio. Domestic wastewater is often the opposite, so that's one of the differences. It may be high in sulfur species, and specifically sulfides cause odor and have some toxicity we need to pay attention to. Different metals, especially if acidic conditions enhance the leaching of metals out of the waste. Chlorides are often very high in leachate, and that's important because chlorides we can't really destroy with any treatment technology. They need to be really either filtered out with reverse osmosis, or the leachate would need to be distilled to remove those. And that's an important parameter for our receiving body. We don't want to fill it full of salt. Dissolved gases might be present in our leachate, which are important for us thinking about kind of health and safety in our leachate treatment systems. Often the leachate system will be connected to the landfill gas system to let us pull off gas that's off-gassing out of the leachate and prevent it from building up places where we don't want it. And lastly, organics. So there could be organics that were buried in the waste that are just leaching out. It could be byproducts of degradation that's leaching down into the leachate. All kinds of different types of organics could end up in our leachate. And something interesting on the organics for leachate, the BOD to COD ratio will decrease over time. So in the beginning, the microbes will eat up all the stuff that they can eat in the landfill. And then over time, there'll be less and less biodegradable material as the waste becomes more stable and inert. But we might still be leaching out these other organics that are not biodegradable. And that means that we might have to take a different strategy closer to the beginning of the landfill life versus the end to treat those organics. We might be able to rely on biological treatment in the beginning, but as the BOD fraction gets smaller and smaller, we might have to change tactics later on. And lastly, organics impart color to leachate, which is something that you definitely don't want to see. It's very concerning for people in surface water bodies. So you can see in the little beaker on the figure, it's just like black, looks really awful. And then in the table beside it, you can see this is just for one site, but just some examples of some of the numbers you can see in leachate. And I put a little emphasis box around the BOD. You can see in the phase three part of operation. This is going back to that really complicated figure with all the different gas concentrations and things like that. So earlier on in the landfill life, if you look at the BOD5 to the COD ratio, it's about 50%. And then later on, it goes down to like 15%. So it really changes over time. So that's one of the complications with leachate treatment. It's not like domestic wastewater where you're getting a constant stream of fresh sewage from your system. Your leachate, once your landfill is closed, it just gets older and older and keeps changing. And that's something that you need to plan for when thinking about how to manage the leachate.